What's up, mobile gamers? It's Johnzer Giggs. Today's video is going to be pretty different. It's going to probably be a little bit shorter, and it's just going to be me talking about what I think of the arcade system. So we're just going to hop into some games with Zero Kelvin. I haven't really played him too much, and we're just going to kind of focus on talking about the arcade and what I think of it. And I would say that my position on the arcade is a lot different compared to a lot of YouTubers and even Three, just people in general. And to be honest, my view is that I don't really care. I am, you know, not the type of person to spend money on a game and you can just not have the hero, you know what I mean? So for me, I don't even need to have the hero necessarily. I did get him for content purposes, but if this was like just when I'm playing the game normally and I'm not a content creator, then I would say it's not too big of a deal to get the hero, and I wouldn't personally care if a game chooses to monetize in any way unless it affects the gameplay. And that's the other thing, is that I would say that it doesn't necessarily affect the gameplay because it's only one hero. It's not like it's all the heroes. And a little bit of lag here, sorry you guys, but the it is lagging pretty bad, but Vincent isn't necessarily like super OP broken, and he's not like, he also doesn't suck super bad, like he's not the worst hero in the game or anything like that. And so for me, it doesn't really affect gameplay because it's not like it actually makes the whole roster bad or anything like that. We're actually going to, hang on, we're going to turn on data real quick. See if that'll get rid of the lagging, possibly. Looks like it is going a little bit better. Okay, so I'm glad we turned off our internet there. We're just going to go with some data real quick. Probably gonna burn my battery really quick, but that's okay. So, the arcade system is not terrible, I would say. I definitely think if they're going to change any of it, it needs to be cheaper. Ooh, nice kill on that Aletta. It definitely needs to be cheaper, but I can also understand why they would do it, because, you know, they, at the end of the day, they do need money to keep this game afloat. And to put Vincent behind a paywall is not the worst idea. Like I said in like my unboxings of Vincent and stuff like that, MechArena also has this kind of style where they will allow you to buy a mech. Now, MechArena is probably really a lot worse compared to T3 Arena, because I wouldn't say that. In MechArena, if you don't have the stuff that they are putting out and you don't have the money to get it, then you pretty much aren't going to be competitive, especially in the higher tiers. We're going to use his ultimate here, see if we can't just clear these guys out. But, so yeah, that's what I'm kind of trying to say, is that it's definitely a justifiable monetization. I can see why they need money, and they decided, let's bring out a hero that not everyone's gonna get. And I would also say, especially comparing it to MechArena, when you buy $100 in MechArena for like the new Mech Bastion or anything like that, you don't get really any extra stuff. And in the arcade mode, you can get coins, you can get point doublers, you can get like the hero shards or whatever you want to, whatever they're called, the power cores for your hero to upgrade them. You can get skins, you can get tokens, that kind of thing. So you really do get a lot of resources with buying stuff in T3 and spending money on the arcade. So it's not like, oh, you're just getting Vincent and he's a busted hero, because he is actually pretty balanced. And I was talking with a fellow YouTuber, and we actually feel like there's a lot of, nice little victory there, we felt that there was a lot of changes that could be made to him kind of smaller quality of life changes that would actually make him easier to play, because he is pretty tough to play. And a lot of it has to do with, the way his kit works, the way he interacts with bots at lower levels, the way his abilities are played in the game. So there's a lot that they could change about him. And I definitely don't think he's OP at all. If anything, I would actually say that Vincent is underpowered because he's super easy to kill, and as long as you pay attention, you can kill him relatively easy, and you can be playing a game and you can see that they have a Vincent, and then as long as you pay attention, he's easily countered. And a lot of people, what they've been doing is they will just, take a shot or two at their teammate if they're not sure. And then if it does end up being a Vincent, then, he just dies right away because he's so squishy, so he has almost no health. So I don't think that the hero being OP is a problem. I think that they definitely could benefit if they were to make Vincent a little bit stronger. I think some more people would get Vincent because he's not necessarily super strong. And the price point could be lowered, but other than that, like, there's a lot of stuff that you get from it, so I can see why they would put it in and think that it's a good idea, because a lot of the stuff you get is worth it, and so your money is decently well spent. It might not be like the best way to progress and stuff, but I do think that if you take out Vincent and it was just resources, that you wouldn't even need to spend your money at all, honestly. You can play this game for free and do really good. So yeah, that's kind of what I'm thinking. I normally don't even spend money on mobile games. Like I said, I only spend money on this game because I'm a YouTuber, and I would say that you don't need to spend money at all to progress all your heroes. Like, if you look at my list of heroes besides Vincent, all my heroes were leveled up through, just playing the game. I never spent any money except for, maybe I'd buy a skin every once in a while, which, what is that, like $25, I think, for one skin. And, that supports T3 Arena and the developers. So I just kind of wanted to make a video for you guys, kind of showcasing what my thoughts were and stuff like that. And I wanted to let you know that I really don't think it's all that bad. Do I think they could adjust the price point and make it cheaper? Absolutely. Do I think that Vincent's OP? No. Do I think that in order to be competitive, you have to buy the stuff that's in the arcade? No, I don't think that either. So let's see if we can't get this labula real quick while we're talking. But the arcade system is not that bad. It should be cheaper. I think that's absolutely a change they need to make. And they also should probably buff Vincent a little bit. But other than that, like, if you also think about this from a developer's perspective, they need money to keep their game afloat. And a lot of the controversy is on the arcade system, almost primarily because it is the first time that they've done any sort of monetization for the game. So you have to also understand that besides skins, which also come with plenty of stuff to level up your account and all that kind of thing, they have only really just now done it once where they have monetized something. And the hero that they have monetized doesn't change the game in such a significant way that you have to spend money in order to keep playing. And so I would honestly say that my stance of not really caring, that should maybe go to a lot of other people, because if you really don't want to spend money on the arcade, then just don't spend money on the arcade. You can still level up your heroes, you can still have fun. And, if you're watching this video, take it from me. I don't think that, you're gonna miss out on so much stuff with Vincent. Just watch a YouTube video or two on him, and that can get your Vincent fix. You know what I mean? So Definitely a price reduction on here, and definitely a few like quality of life changes to Vincent, but I don't think that it's as big of a deal as a lot of people are making it out to be. And so I would say if you're going to worry about it, then you can worry about it. But I'm here to tell you that it's not too big of a deal. Just, don't spend your money if you don't want to. T3 Arena doesn't look like they're going in the pay-to-win route. They've been doing a really good job of listening to the community and putting out good content, putting out heroes. Zero Kelvin is pretty much balanced, I would say. I don't think he needs a nerf or a buff. And all the heroes that they have released that have been OP, they have fixed that almost right away. So I really don't think we need to worry too much about T3 Arena becoming pay to win. I don't think they're going to, release a hero in, like, they might put one hero into the arcade, but then you can still get that hero and Vincent if you haven't spent with the arcade. So it won't actually get worse. If you look at the heroes, right, there are 25 heroes. Is that right? 15, 20, 25. Yeah. So there's 25 heroes. And if you take away Vincent, then it's 24. So you have 24 other choices that you can pretty much get for free and that you can level up. And then I would also say, you think about, oh, well, what about a max level Vincent? And I would say that, sure, his passive is good, but you don't need his passive to be good with him. And I think that that goes for every hero. And there's ways to get their second ultimates and their passives super easily now. And all of those ways, except for the arcade, are by playing. So for me, when we're looking at like the Road to Fire and the Rage Ball and the three times trophy challenge and even the Heat Star challenge, like all of that is free to play and you get rewards and you rank up your heroes and you can unlock their passives through the Rumble boxes you get in the progress path right here. You can get power cores. So I think that there's so many options that for them to release the arcade, they were just kind of like, hey, if some people want to spend money, let's give them something to spend money on, like a cool new hero. But he's not breaking the game. He's not a must-pick hero. He's not a must-have. I would say he's not even competitive. I would say he's not made for high-level play at all. Because if you go against somebody who's played this game even like 10 matches, they're going to notice the difference, like, oh, Vincent's on the enemy team, and now I gotta make sure my teammates aren't Vincent. Like, that's it. And so when you're talking about this kind of stuff, I think that the devs recognize that they've done so much for the game that's free, and you can really level up your heroes. Like I said, if you look, all my heroes are max, and I did that without paying any money. I've played since pretty much day one, and I have leveled up everybody without any money. So, for those that are content creators or what we call whales in the gacha community, where they will just spend their whole paycheck on, pulling for a character, and I would say that the arcade's not even fully a gacha system because you can get so much stuff from it, even if you don't get Vincent. And comparatively to gacha games, it's actually cheaper. So, out of all of the monetization that locks a hero or, like in Mech Arena, a mech behind a paywall, it's like the most lenient and the cheapest. So I think you guys, some of you might be overreacting. Some of you guys might be like, oh, this is exactly what I was thinking. I'm so glad you said that. But I think it's a pretty good choice. I think it should be a little bit cheaper. And I think they should do a little bit more to Vincent. That's pretty much my only concerns with it. And as far as like the overall long-term health of the game, I don't think it's going to affect the game negatively at all. And you also got to remember that if you stack everything that they have done for the community up to this point against the arcade system, it far outweighs the arcade system. There are so many ways that you can get free things. And if you look at the store, obviously, since I have all the heroes, you would not see anything on the store, but if you don't have all the heroes, you can get power cores for free or for a small amount of coins, and there's usually six slots, and then you get free stuff every day. The only monetization until the arcade was just skins. So that's kind of my thoughts on the arcade. I wanted to let you guys know what I really felt about it, and I don't think it's that big of a deal. If anything, like, just ignore it because Vincent's not that good, and if you don't want to spend money, don't spend money. So that's kind of my two cents on the issue. I really don't think it's too big of a deal, and I'm probably rambling and saying the same thing over and over again, but I just kind of want to show you guys why it's not something to be afraid over. I think if they started releasing like five and six heroes into the arcade system, then that's, some cause for concern. But where it is now, I don't think it's too big of a deal. Save your money, like I said, buy the battle pass and subscribe to the monthly like I have. I think if you guys do those two things, if you're gonna spend money, that's a better option, and I've made a short on that on YouTube. But the arcade system, it's kind of a middle ground, especially compared to a lot of other games, a lot of gacha games, a lot of games like Mecharena or War Robots that are pay to win. It kind of has that element, but it doesn't actually affect the game in the same way that it does in the other games that I've just said. So just wanted to let you guys know, don't get your knickers in a twist or anything like that. I don't think the arcade system is anything to worry about. I think that we should stick with the devs on this one and, trust that they know what they're doing, because I'm all and you just go back to all the free stuff that they're giving us, linking your socials, the Road to Fire, the Ice Fire Festival, all of that. And I think it just shows that, they're doing a lot for the community. So to say that they are greedy and released this arcade system to get money out of all of the players because they're greedy or because they don't care about the free-to-play players is, I just think that's kind of reaching because, even the pay-to-win players, they can get Vincent all they want and play with him all they want, but at the end of the day, there's 24 other heroes that you can get up to the same level in a free-to-play manner that are still better than Vincent. I would say that Vincent is easily on C or D tier if I were to make a tier list. So, don't be worrying about the arcade system, you guys. Definitely check out Jordy's video once it's up. He's going to talk about it as well. He has a different perspective than I do, and I think that if you combine this video with his, it'll give you a good thought process and roadmap to how people are thinking of this. And I think that the natural reaction when somebody releases anything in a game that is something you have to pay for, the natural reaction is, oh my God, they don't care about free-to-play players. And I don't think that's the case with T3 Arena. I think that it's just, it's your natural gut reaction to be like, oh my God, I don't want to have to spend money in order to play this game. And so I feel like that's why a lot of people have been freaking out as they don't want to have to drop this game just because they don't have money. And, I can absolutely understand that. I spent like $150 to get Vincent, and I'm not super huge on YouTube, so I'm not going to see any of that money back. And I'm in college with a part-time job, and so money's pretty tight for me too. So I definitely understand, those people who are like, I don't want to spend money just to play a mobile game. You know what I mean? And most of my money goes to my bills. So for me to spend money on the arcade system, it's like, well, I don't spend my money anywhere else. So for me, that's why I spent money. And pocket change players, I think that pocket change players can do really good in this game because, $3 or $4 for, some of the stuff that's in here or these specials, those are really good too. If you're a lower level player and you need those rumble boxes or those coins or those power cores. So I think that a lot of people are overreacting, but I can also understand how those people are like, we're just trying to show that we care about the game. We don't want it to go to a pay to win kind of mentality from the devs. And so I just wanted to let you guys know, I really don't think that that's where they're going. And I really don't think the arcade system is like a bad omen or anything like that. I think the game is really healthy right now. It's in a really good spot. I think this is like the biggest season of the seasons that they've had so far. This is the most balanced Battle Pass hero. It's got the most, ways that you can earn stuff as a free-to-play player. And so I think a lot of people are just overreacting and they're just concerned. So I don't think that people are hating the T3 devs or anything like that. And I myself, I totally support them. I totally understand. They just want to make money so that their game can stay afloat. And at the end of the day, that's the bottom line. They're running a company and they're trying to keep this game out there for us. And I think they're honestly doing a really good job. So, support for pretty much everybody. If you're a whale, good power, all the power to you. You spend your money on the game. Pocket change players, get the battle pass, get the subscription. People that don't spend money on the game, don't even worry about it. You can just level up your heroes for free. So, only reason I bought them again was for YouTube content. So, I think everybody can, watch my video, tell me what you think in the comments, drop a sub if you like the content, all that kind of stuff. And, let me know what you guys really think. If you wanna, trash my video for supporting the devs, that's cool too. Totally understand. And, you guys have a good day. And hopefully you had a good Christmas as well. That's my 2 cents on the issue.